long is two quickies? Measurement is important in science and indeed everyday life. But how do we know, for example, how long something is? I have a ruler, so I'll just measure it with the ruler and it'll tell me how many inches it is. But here's a question they probably didn't teach you to ask in school. How do I know this ruler is accurate? There might have been a manufacturing defect. Maybe instead of 12 inches, this ruler is really 11.5 inches. How can I tell? Well, I've got another ruler here, so I'll just measure it. Yep, 12 inches. But wait, all I did was compare one ruler to another. If one ruler is off, how do I know the other one isn't? These are two completely different kinds of rulers, made with completely different processes. This ruler is wood, while this one is plastic. They were made in different factories, maybe even by different companies. And while it's possible, but unlikely, for either of them to be off, it's very unlikely for both of them to be off. And even if they are both off, what are the chances that they would be off by the exact same amount in the exact same direction? This is sounding pretty unlikely to me. This is what science looks for, not only how accurate a method of measurement is, but how well it agrees with other methods. Creationists, for some reason, love making a big deal about carbon dating. But the idea isn't that carbon dating is 100% accurate and reliable, it's the fact that it agrees with other forms of dating. Think about it. If carbon dating were off, how would you know? Only comparing it to other methods, like with the rulers. And if it agrees with argon dating, and it agrees with isochron dating, and it agrees with dendrochronology, and it agrees with tetrachronology, and like with the rulers, if all of these methods give the same results, it's a pretty safe bet that they're accurate. It's just like with astronomy, parallax, Cepheid variables, standard sirens, main sequence fitting, type 1a supernovae, redshifts. All of these methods giving the same results can give us a high degree of confidence that we can measure these distances reliably. Measuring something is a lot more tricky than they taught you in school, but that does not mean that it's unreliable.